Today I have come to the fields to fly my foil kite. It worked a bit like an aeroplane wing. So this is the foil kite itself. As you can see, there are holes at the top so that the air can go in, but it's all stitched up at the bottom so it can't actually go out. This inflates and creates an aeroplane wing shape. So the shape means that the air goes over the top faster than it goes under the bottom. This creates the lift. But if there's not enough wind, you can't fly the kite. This is an example of not having enough wind to create the lift to keep the kite in the air. Therefore, it just collapses and gravity pulls it down. On a windy day, it works really well. Sometimes it creates so much lift, it nearly takes me off my feet.
You may wonder how an incredibly heavy aircraft like this manages to stay airborne during flight. Well, in this video, I'm going to explain the concept of how it works to you. It's mainly down to the plane's wing shape. This is a side-on view of one of the plane's wings. As the plane starts to pick up speed, the air on top flows faster, whereas the air below flows slower. This then creates higher pressure below the wing and lower pressure above the wing. The high air pressure then tries to equalise the low pressure but pushes against the wing instead, creating lift, therefore allowing the plane to take off.